Picture this. You like fast cars, but you're also a practical person. You love the engagement of a nice and fast car, how it goes fast on the streets, and how it properly hugs the corners. But you also want something practical that you could have for the daily. And so that begs the question, is there a ride that you could properly have around that could give you the best of both worlds? Well, let's find out. Rev fam, Toby Tejano here, and you're tuned in to Rev Plus, your ultimate guide to choosing your next ride, and so much more. This here is the all-new Subaru Crosstrek. And to anyone who's been familiar of Subarus of the past, you gotta know that this is a go-anywhere type of ride. Boxer engines, symmetrical all-wheel drive, and Subaru EyeSight are some of the many features that made this ride famous with everyone. And some time ago, this was also known as the XV, and that perfectly blended with our Philippine market. But recently, the Subaru XV became the Subaru Crosstrek. So now the question is, how does this dependable ride get even better? Well, let's talk about it. The Subaru Crosstrek first drove into the scene back in 2012. This was known as the XV, and it was based on the Impreza platform. And everyone loved how this ride gave a perfect blend of size and performance, making it a ride that you could enjoy in the city, in the open road, or even off-road. From the get-go, this was a ride already known for having one of the highest ground clearance figures in its segment, making it a ride that you could enjoy because of all of its practicality while maintaining the comfort that a sedan could give you. It was around 2017 which became a pivotal moment for the XV as the addition of Subaru EyeSight came along, adding so many safety features while internationally dropping the name XV and completely incorporating the name Crosstrek to the brand. As time passed, the Crosstrek has been properly embraced by the market, both locally and internationally. It is a Subaru that you want to have because this is a ride that's not just a vehicle, but also a companion on every journey. For today, we're here to see how this compact crossover SUV invites you to turn it up. For today's episode, let me show you around. And after all of that, let's take it for a drive. Bolder yet safer. Those are the sentiments of the all-new Crosstrek. There's a more modern look to this ride, but it has kept true to its form. With its newest version, Subaru has now given this ride a stiffer underbody, but a softer spring and suspension system, which gives you so much dependability while giving you as much comfort as possible. The upgrades are also seen in the safety features of this ride. But before we talk about that, let's talk about one thing everyone likes about the Subaru, and that's what's under the hood. Under the hood of the all-new Subaru Crosstrek, what you're getting is a 2-liter 4-cylinder boxer engine with a continuously variable transmission, or also known as a CVT. And that also has an 8-speed manual override as seen with your paddle shifters. Now, according to Subaru, what you also get is a top speed of approximately 198 kilometers per hour and a standing acceleration time from 0 to 100 kph at around 10.5 seconds. But for today, we're not going to be testing top speed anytime soon. After all, safety first. But what I want to point out is this. What's under the hood of the all-new Crosstrek? Now, if you're familiar with Subarus of the past, you'll know how unique the layout of this engine is. But from a mechanic's point of view, you like the idea that everything is still easy access. What's new about the all-new Crosstrek though is that there are now added sound dampening materials which just doesn't lessen vibrations for this ride, but also gives you a more quiet ride. With the hood closed, this is what the all-new Crosstrek looks like. Now, you'll notice the front grille here and how consistent it stays with the overall design language of Subaru. It goes well with the new color scheme that you have for this new Crosstrek. You'll also notice your LED headlights up on top and your fog lamps down below. One thing you'll also notice with the all-new Crosstrek is how it gives a more modern look by giving a sharper design. And that stays consistent all throughout the entire exterior of this ride. What also sticks out is all the amount of plastic that you have for this crossover. Now you might be wondering why. What's with all these plastics considering the fact that this is a Subaru priced at a special way? But this is a ride that's ready for any adventure, so having those plastic touches there is a good thing. Why? Because if you get any damages with these particular components, it's gonna be easy to fix. So all things considered, when you look at the Crosstrek, this is a ride that's ready for adventures, or your misadventures. So let's talk about what the all-new Crosstrek looks like from the side. Now, first things first, let's talk about ground clearance. Now, for ground clearance for the all-new Crosstrek, what you get is 220 millimeters of ground clearance. Now, the good thing with 220 millimeters of ground clearance is that considering the overall width and length of this car, it properly goes well with the overall look. And so driving this car is very practical, especially for the daily. And that 220 millimeters of ground clearance, it goes well with the approach, the departure angle, and the breakover angle if in case you go overlanding. Now, beyond overlanding, let's talk about your wheels. Now, you have 18-inch black alloy wheels here, which is a new design element for this year. Now, with your 18-inch wheels, what you also get are plastic fenders. Interesting enough, though, with the plastic fenders on each side of the car, you'll also get these particular divots here. Three little holes here, which is a nice overall touch to the car. Now, I'm not sure if that affects the overall aerodynamics of the ride, but it does add airflow for the Crosstrek, which could also go well if in case you want to go on an adventure. Speaking of adventure, if you're going to be stuck in the city, you're going to enjoy this little panel here because it gives you more visibility. It's a familiar sight compared to other Subarus, and it's pretty nice to see that it's still here on the new Crosstrek. And one last thing I want to point out with the side profile of this ride are your roof rails up on top. They're not just your ordinary roof rails because there are spaces underneath, which means you could be able to put aftermarket parts for this ride if in case you want to go overlanding. Now let's talk about what this compact crossover looks like from the back. And this is what it looks like in the back of the all-new Subaru Crosstrek. Now for this crossover, you'll notice the continuation of the sharp design elements as seen with your rear taillights. That's a good thing because it gives the ride a more modern look. It also goes well with the shark's fin antenna that you have up on top and your bumper down below. But there's also added elements of durability with this ride. Now what I really like about the Crosstrek in general is that this is a ride that could be ready for any adventure. Not just because of its performance, because of all the things that this ride has that makes it easy to maintain and easy to fix in the long run. Now, one more thing I want to talk about with this ride is how much this crossover can carry. And this is what cargo capacity looks like. Now for the back of the all-new Crosstrek, you're getting a familiar sight here if you've ever seen the XV before. You still have the same 291 liters of space here with the seats in place, and the space does add up, especially when you fold those seats down. It's a nice touch to know that those seats also fold flat, giving you the best space possible. Now, what you like here in the back is that, first of all, when you look at the back of the Crosstrek, you'll notice that everything is accessible, but also everything is fixable right away. Meaning, there's not a lot of electronics here in the back, and so if you have to clean or fix anything in the long run, it's gonna be an easy thing to do. A trip to the beach, a quick hike, it's not gonna be a problem if you put things here in the back because after that adventure, everything's gonna be easy to clean. But if you're gonna be in the city, you're gonna like this little touch here. This is a tonneau cover here, which gives you more privacy and insulation, especially if you're gonna be carrying delicate or fragile items. It's nice to know that this tonneau cover is also easily removable. Now, one more detail I wanna point out for the back of the Crosstrek is this right here. When you take a look at this, This is where you could hide the seatbelt if in case nobody will be sitting here in the middle. That's a nice and efficient touch to have. But if you're gonna be having a passenger in the middle, you could always easily pull this out and route it through here so that the passenger could be able to safely sit there in the middle. Now, one last detail I gotta point out about the Crosstrek is right here. Now, as you can see, I'm carrying a tumbler, and take a look at this little detail. There's a cup holder in the back of this car. And come to think of it, there's also a cup holder here. So ideally, you could be able to have people sitting here in the back and you could have a convenient place for your drinks. Now, again, though, it wouldn't be ideal to be sitting here while the car is moving, but this is a nice place to hang out at, especially if you're gonna be at the beach with somebody, probably talking about something special, the future maybe, I don't know, up to you. But enough about that, let's talk about the rest of the car.